The actual question was whether or not this would work for a floating jab or a reconnaissance jab. And it's like, no. And if you're in a fight and somebody's just throwing a reconnaissance jab, you're not going to play there. You're not going to involve yourself in gaining distance or closure on that, because he's just feeling you out. And if that's the case, you're most likely not in a street fight. You're in a tournament. So this doesn't apply to a tournament. So we're looking at something that's a little more committed, somebody that has intent, whether it's, you know, they're all out to kill you or they have several different things coming at you. And one of our other people that trained with us said that he got in a fight recently. And he said it was just like the movie. The guy got all angry and actually came at him with both hands to his throat. And he said, just like in the movies. He says, you don't think it really happens, but this actually happened. So when Josh is working here against Anna, who there is a big height difference. So if Anna's even just demonstrating an overhand elbow or an over-the-top elbow, you can see she can make clearly land it on his jaw. How tall are you?
About 6'2".
About 6'2". Okay, and you're 5'4"? Something like that? Okay. So clearly an over-the-top elbow, okay, or a down elbow is going to make contact with the jaw. So in this particular case too, if he has an intent and we train with intent, it changes the structure of how this actually occurs. If Josh is just out here, you know, doing his little jab, she's not going to sit there and try and work this, because there's no way somebody's going to be able to fit that into play. Now, she's going to keep range, so if she's going to get a sense right off the bat whether or not this person has got some skill or not. If this is a surprise attack, you aren't going to get that option, you aren't going to get that opportunity. But if she is able to judge range and be able to move back and forth, she'll be able to start working timing on this and be able to play just like they were doing earlier. So if this punch comes on in, pop, she can recycle this and keep working timing on the punch. And this is how we get better and better on our timing on this, because he'll change this and he'll change his timing. He'll break this up. He won't be as obvious. Later on, it'll be quicker and quicker, and which means that she has to adapt just as quickly. Now, if we're going for a street-type scenario, we're going to go with he's coming out to choke her. Now, if we're working against a wall or something like that, the scenario of somebody grabbing somebody's throat and holding them so they can punch them is a real scenario. This occurs in street fights a lot. It's a sense of power and control and holding somebody in place. So if Josh goes with that intention, I'm going to go with that. The same rules apply for this particular thing. For this particular drill, she will go ahead and she will wrap. That first one is an elbow strike if she happens to get close enough to him. If not, doesn't matter. She will pull the lock off, and you can see from the other angle, if you rotate around, you can see from that other angle, she's able to grab the meaty part of the thumb, turn it out into a supine lock while she does a down elbow. And you can see that it doesn't matter her size, she is able to sink that in there. So we're going to get Josh into a little chest plate here. So are you feeling this at all, Josh?
The penetration, yes.
Okay.
No pain.
Okay. So on the same mechanics, if he's going for a throat, she goes and turns out, lands it, smacks it dab, center. So a shot in the chest, chest plate, works really well because it is a shocking thing. Strikes to that aren't a skimming and downward strike. What happens is you want your angle to penetrate and go down and through the body and out the other side. So it's a forward shot more than a downward scrape. When we're working on the head like this, this is more downward, but we're not actually going in a path like this, because I don't want to just cut them. I want to actually rock the brain inside it. So the angle will be backwards like this, so that shot comes in directly like that and over the head, and her angle coming in there just like that from somebody of her height will land up into the face just like that. It'll rock the jaw, it'll set him back. He won't be able to eat for the next few weeks, except through a straw. And so you can see it does work.